vengeful spirit.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Dark Seer.
Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So apology for the sound stream for a while, guys. I'm just trying to make sure that the stream actually switched over. So Eternity have replaced Boar in the playoffs because Boar didn't feel like playing anymore. So I thought, you know what, maybe I have a little bit of time to get another match in to have a little bit of fun, but they decided to get someone else to replace. So Mad Kings will play up against Eternity here. Eternity have not really done too well at all in the group stage of COD League, so we'll just have to see how they work in the playoffs. Mad Kings, they were at the top of Group A, so this theoretically should be a pretty easy game for them. I'm just trying to make sure that the stream goes up correctly, and I won't be able to do that for another 30 seconds. So we are in the draft here between the two teams. Mad Kings going with the Shrak Vengeful Spirit to start. My sound's probably in the earphones. So the Lashrak should be able to push in pretty quickly, and also he has a nice setup there with the magic missile stun, so he should be able to hit the split earth pretty much every time.
10 seconds remaining.
Eternity, they do have the Shadow Demon and Darkseer to try to stop that.
Remaining.
So the Darkseer has definitely factored into the Darkseer has definitely factored into a lot of wins here for teams. So we'll see what Eternity can work out with it. Shadow Demon is not really Radiant going to be too much of a big combo hero factor there, but Eternity still have quite a bit of draft to go through. Sven has not been banned out by Mad King, so that is something that Eternity could go for when it's their turn to pick.
5 seconds remaining.
That is not what
Reserve
I wanted.
Reserve time.
I guess that's the one for later today. So we do have two series Dire up in the playoffs. These are best of threes, by the way. And the second match is going to be FDL versus Duop. FDL just getting over the border there into the playoffs by beating ENG 2-0 yesterday. So FDL Duop will be the second match of the night.
5 seconds remaining.
So we still have a lot of things to get set up right now as we go through the draft. So quite a few things on my end to work around here. Yeah, I guess that'll do. So we're going through the draft still. Eternity banning out the Timbersaw and the Juggernaut with their second bans there, second group. The Juggernaut could work pretty well with the stuns that Mad Kings have, and also has been known for pushing fairly quickly, which the Vengeful Spirit and the Lashrak, they're also fairly good at facilitating as well. But make no mistake, I definitely would predict Mad Kings to win this one. Even when Eternity looked like they were doing well yesterday, it was really just not even close at all. Mad Kings picking up the Ogre here, meaning that we're going to be able to see a Corvenge or a mid Lashrak. Most likely a Corvenge here for Mad Kings. It's generally the way their drafts have been going. Liking this quite a bit with the Ogre Magi. A couple of... There's the Aura and the Bloodlust able to buff up Vengeful Spirit. And very good for early pressure and control.
Reserve time.
Just trying to figure out what I'm going to need to change on this. I think I could take the current standings out. And then we'll have our matches for tonight.
Gyrocopter!
Interesting gyro for Eternity. Now, that was picked up yesterday. And it seemed to work well. But I'm still not very convinced that a gyrocopter is always going to be the best idea. I guess what they're looking for is just a lot of AoE around the Darkseer vacuum. You can drop down the cooldown onto...
5 seconds.
Whatever Darkseer gets in the vacuum, but you're still kind of relying on the combo to hit before you can do anything.
10 seconds remaining.
So we'll have to see if this works out for Eternity. Meanwhile, Mad Kings pick up the Legion Commander. This is another strong pickup for them. They might try to run it mid. They might put it in the offlane. There are really endless possibilities. So Mad Kings, they're gonna see what they can do with this Legion. The Leshrac definitely can help out quite a bit when it comes to those duels. And also Legion should be able to keep Gyrocopter there as long as he hasn't gotten the magic damage off before. She should be able to win the duel pretty handily against him. So I wasn't really expecting to have anything more here. Especially with board dropping out. So we're still trying to get things set up. So,
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, Eternity will go with the Earth Spirit. Again, I guess a little bit of synergy with the Darkseer. You can get the Kick and Silence through. So there's a nice little combo happening there. Haven't noticed that Darkseer doesn't seem to have a nose. He's got a really pointy head. I guess he doesn't need a nose. Unlike most of these Dota heroes. Actually, Earth Spirit doesn't seem to have a nose either. He's just got a really flat front of the face. If you think about it, smell's a kind of strange concept, actually. I'm sure that not everybody would be able to use that sense all that much, or as much as other species do. In fact, humans don't really use it all that well either. So I guess the Darkseer doesn't really need to smell all that much. I guess he has a couple of nose holes right there.
Team pick.
Can't tell what Juggernaut has under the mask. Shadow Fiend probably doesn't need to smell
Dragon
anything.
Knight.
Dire team pick.
But in any case, Eternity will pick up the tanky Dragon Knight to try to fulfill their damage soaking goals here for the early part of the game. And that might be an interesting matchup against the Legion Commander if they decide to put
10 seconds remaining.
Her mid.
5 seconds remaining.
Ursa Warrior.
And Mad Kings will pick up the Ursa to finish this off. So, just looking at this one, it should be the Vengeful Spirit Core Liege Commander as the offlaner, then Ursa in the mid for Mad Kings. Man, that just looks terrible. I think I will move that scroll text over. Yeah, I think that'll work. Do I have any sponsors that I shouldn't? I don't think I do. I think that the two sponsors that we have, yeah, I think they're still fine. We have been switching things around a little bit. So the good news is you guys aren't going to have as many ads to watch anymore.
5 seconds remaining.
You'll just have the Dota 2 Lounge, I believe, and GGBet as the sponsors for this tournament. And I am covering this off of Dota TV, so we'll get to the free camera there. Wasn't able to get to the lobby in time because I had better things to do than to get here. Don't really appreciate when people put in teams that probably shouldn't be in the playoffs at all. But at least it's going to fill out the bracket, making it so that all the games end up getting played. This was a problem that the last COD League also had. They had a couple of teams dropping out when it came to later stages of the event. Just didn't really feel like competing anymore. Can I kind of understand it with a couple of members of Boar being European? It's not really the most fun event to do, especially when not winning all that much. I guess we are going to be ready to get on with this one. So here we go. Alright, smoke right off the bat from Eternity. Gonna send Mario down to the bottom lane on the Shadow Demon. He's got the Observer Ward in tow. Sword running down the bottom. He's been doing really well as the offlaner for Mad Kings. And they seem to be doing quite well as a team so far. Really starting to figure out the patch. They had a little bit of trouble with it as not today, but now with the lineup that they have, they are working pretty well together. Maybe the Legion getting caught up a little bit at bottom, and she may have been scouted out while putting down the Observer Ward, and Mario will be able to scout that one out. So that is the advantage that comes with getting the TP out to the lane very quickly.
30 seconds to battle.
So the bounty runes should just go to each team on the respective sides. Firefly is starting to make his way over the top. Wolf Harass is sword away from the shrine there. And he's going to come around the side, but that's a very aggressive position for a solo gyrocopter to be. He's got to back up there. He does. Starting to go up to the high ground, maybe looking for the bounty rune. They're going to be a little bit late, and NRS is there. Can they get the stun? They'll just drop the ignite. Wasn't really the thing that they want. Shadows here, they've got the stun if they want it, but MJW already puts the iron shot, so they know that he wouldn't be able to surge away, but that is a little bit more damage than Mad Kings would want to be taking. Plus, they have to get back over to the top lane. Actually getting a nice block at mid. Madara will finally get the bounty rune on his side of the map. And that's what some early vision can do for you. If you don't see the enemy team going into the jungle there. Now, they actually know that MJW doesn't have any levels into the surge. And with the stun missing, he actually is going to be able to get out. Shadow a little bit off the mark with that split earth so that the Darkseer was able to TP away. And he TPs all the way back to the base, so he's not going to try for any plays, say, going back to the tier 1 tower or anything like that, going back to the shrine. He's just going to go right back to the base, not really wasting any of those resources right now, but when he gets back to the lane, that's going to be a bit more of a difficult Mad King squad that he's going into. Maybe a level 2 up for them as well. You see Madara getting them levels up. Darkseer should get there fast enough, and he's going to go into the jungle instead. Now some damage out in the sword at bottom. He's just standing in the middle of everything, hardly even cares. Rocket Barrage is being soaked up by the creep wave. Destruction comes out. Wolf does have another Rocket Barrage in 2 seconds. Oh, roll is going to be off the mark. Will sword go down? They need some vision of sword to be able to do this, and the creep wave is going to be in there to save him. He was just standing in the middle of everything, and even then, they could not take him down. NRS will be forced away from the mid lane. Now he's so tanky. There will be a TP in. Reefire keeping him alive a little bit. NRS, there's going to be a slow. Firefly is caught up in here, but Remy, he might get things turned around on him. Ajin has to get through the creep wave, and he's not going to be able to. Just caught up in them so much, plus those guys were so low. So much is going to be up in the mid lane to farm. NRS gets back here. That death is not going to be fun for him. Here comes the roll. Ajin getting slowed down. he's trying to get over to the shrine, and he should be able to. That's a good thing for the ogre and Ursa to be able to get right now. So that'll allow Ursa to stay on the mid lane a little bit longer. Maybe also put some more aggression on the Dragonite Ren. He's got some pretty good mana. And Breathe Fire forces Atrium back for now. Doesn't really want to go through it. Sword picking up the Invis rune. Gets over to the easy camp there. Just gets the last hit from it. I'm sure that was totally worth it. Fireflies is at level 2 now. He's gone for Ignite and the Bloodlust, so no stun just yet for him. And really the only thing that he's going to need it for is a Darkseer. Now we commander is going to get slowed down. Lots of damage from the Rocket Barrage. He uses the Overwhelming Odds to try to turn this around. Stun comes through. Sword taking a lot of damage. There will be the missile coming in. Sword could be in some trouble. Wolf trying to follow him down, but that is only the Rocket underneath the tower. And Wolf gets so low as a result of that. Sword just gets back to the shrine for now. Not even scared at all. He just Overwhelming Odds press the attack, and he's completely fine.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
So right now, Mad Kings, they are winning nearly every single lane. And just the fact that the Legion hasn't died causes her to be winning. She goes into the trees, picks up some items. She has a poor man's shield now, and the boots of speed. She'll put out the Overwhelming Odds, chasing down Wolf. Mario will probably be forced, well, he's not going to be forced into the disruption, but he could have needed to use it onto Legion. Atrium's just having a party at mid. He'll get NRS out of there, and he times that well enough that he gets both of the last hits with the Earth Shock as well. He's being as efficient as possible at mid, and he'll even find the Illusion Rune to fill up his bottle. Now with the smoke used by Fireflies, he'll be going down towards bottom. Maybe ready to put out some more pressure. Sword would like to be able to get a kill early. He was kind of close on a few, but just being a solo Reach Commander made it so that he wasn't able to actually find it. Fireflies over to the side. Mario, he's got the disruption up in 3 seconds. Here comes the Ignite, and he will actually fall dead in the bottom lane. Missile comes out from Wolf. It's in on Sword. He's going to actually step forward here right into the middle of the creep wave. Wolf has no idea where those Rocket Barrage procs are going, and Remy, he's going to find things turned around him. Another Rocket Barrage. Sword getting very low. He's healing up right now. Can they get the damage out? He's just so tanky right now. So is Fireflies. Firefly chasing him down. He'll find the kill. Rocket Barrage not going to do enough. Fireflies taking the full brunt of the creep wave. Sword gets in this one. That's going to be the overwhelming odds and the kill as well. Mad Kings all over the place at bottom, showing dominance over Eternity. With Iron Shells placed down by MJW. Deny is available, at least to make sure that the creep wave doesn't take too much damage from it. Atrium at level 6, Dragonite still at level 5. He'll stay alive against Ursa, even putting out the Breathe Fire to make sure that his damage is decreased. But already, they're making a play to go for Dragon Knight. He does have level 6. Maybe he even goes to his dragon form. Would be doing a little bit more damage there. Atun, he's got quite a bit. He's waiting for that Legion Commander to come around the backside. Does NRS get away? He doesn't have any vision of it. He goes over to the top side looking for the rune. He's going to get chased away by Ursa. Ursa should probably be in this fight if the Legion Commander wants to go. And they're going to go for it right now. Here comes the Overwhelming Odds. There's going to be the taunt. Nice down through. But the Split Earth does manage to hit. Unfortunately, Atun a little bit too far away. They should be able to kill off the Dragon Knight anyway. They don't get the dual damage though. That's perfectly fine for Mad Kings. They don't need the dual damage on LC for now. Ursa gets the missile on the back, and just nice way of picking up from Legion Commander. Another one going the way of Mad Kings, keeping Eternity down all over the map. Wolf is on the mid lane, but exactly what can he do here other than die? He's got level 4. Mario's ready to come up with the disruption. He's gonna put it out. Caught out here. Diabolically doing a little bit of damage. Shadow not really getting that on the tower. Atsu takes some damage from his own illusions, mostly from the Breathe Fire. That Centaur makes it so that Eternity cannot push in at all. TP in. Sword uses to suppress the attack. And Atsu is back in fighting shape. Going to the creep wave again. Breathe Fire will slow him down. Just waiting for both of those last hits. And meanwhile, we did have the Darkseer getting some farm elsewhere on the map. so it's not all bad for Eternity, but it is certainly quite a bit of damage that they're sustaining on the map. Legion Commander making your armlet for now. There'll be a Blink Dagger off of that. Maybe NRS in trouble at mid. Firefly's ready with the stun, but it's not really that time for the aggression from Mad Kings. Madara farming in the jungle does have the Helmet Dominator. They're trying to go... I mean, they're just waiting for Altoon to get into a bad position, but he's not going to do it. They have plenty of vision there, knowing exactly what's going on astride the mid lane. And they're forced to go back elsewhere on the map. Now it's a solo Ogre versus NRS in the mid lane. Ogre's nearly level 5. Dragonite's not doing too well at all. Hasn't even touched the mid lane tower. And he's supposed to be able to do that with the Elder Dragon form. Here comes the pressy attack from Sword. Getting some damage onto the Ancients. Nice little bit of farm for him. Until Mad Kings get their items up, they're really just waiting for some aggression from Eternity before they really go for some more fights. Shadow gets over towards the rune spot, and he'll pick it up away from NRS. He won't be able to get a bottle charge from that one. TP in from Shadow Demon, looking to see if anything can happen here. Toughness R, that's a Wild Wing Ripper doing the dance of its people, and it's also going to get away from the lane. Now possibly Eternity with the Gyrocopter caught out of bottom. Long range swap from Madara. That was so long. There's the duel as well. Finally, Sword feels like a winner. And Mad Kings are free to keep pushing this in as well. Where the Earth is at. He's farming Ancients for now. And what does he have being delivered? That will be his Morphin Mask. A little bit of speed for him as well. He'll smoke up. That will probably be for an early Rouge, while the rest of his team goes to work on bottom. Again, Mad Kings take another one off the map, and there is no reply just yet from Eternity. They are still trying to push in top, but it's going way too slow for them. Wolf gets in there, but he's just a lowly Gyrocopter. He doesn't really do all that much. Trying to work through the creep wave. His flat cannon is down. Mad King's getting the Diabolic Edict on bottom, and all these tier 1 towers have evaporated, except for the one at mid. Mad King's take 3 towers off the map. Eternity have yet to take one. They might be able to get the one at top. Fortify is available. They should use it here. Mad King's do it there. They might decide to keep pushing this in. If Eternity never respond, Mad Kings can just go for this. Meanwhile, Ursa's inside the Roshan pit. He's having a great time. Like a party in there. So finally, Eternity do manage to take a tower, but they are still so far behind at this point. Optum gets the Aegis. The rest of his team creating the space that he needs to do that. And it is time for a tier 1 tower to fall in the mid lane. The last tier 1 that Mad Kings have to take here. Mad Kings start to work onto the tier 1 tower. Diabolic Edict melts it down. Shadow is able to take it out. And here they keep going. It's going to be just a train that never stops in Eternity. They're not going to be finding a whole lot of success here. Sword ready with the overwhelming odds. The stone roll comes through. NRS is just here. A dragon looking for someone to try to hit. Dragon Tail does hit onto the Ogre Magi now, but it's just an ogre that you can't kill. Eternity pause it. I can only imagine that, well, either they have some kind of technical issue or they're calling it a GG at this point. It's only 11 minutes and 20 seconds in, but it's already a nearly 10,000 gold lead for Mad Kings, 4,000 for XP. If they wanted to make a push for Kiev, I know that Eternity aren't really the best opponents to really make this kind of example with, but Mad Kings, they have looked quite good. They finished at the top of Group A in the group stage. We'll have to see how they do in the playoffs, but this is a pretty good start for them. So Mad King's just one range creep to work through, and then they'll start to work again on the tier 2 tower, working with the Diebog, getting up to level 4 right now. Healed up by Press the Attack. They just melt this tower down. Also will come through. MKW, he's looking for the vacuum into wall. He's got vacuum at level 2. It's not the biggest thing. Shadow is ready. Okay, Atu takes a lot of damage. That might be the Aegis being popped. Yeah, that last hit from NRS does take him. He starts to look for the continuation of that, but with the stun coming in onto MKW, he's being slowed down by the Ignite as well. That's just going to result in the tower going down anyway to Mad Kings, and the tower denied away from the vacuum back. There's the nice call down as well. Madara's taking a lot of damage, but it doesn't really matter. Disruption will keep the Darkseer alive for now. They'll just keep walking through the wall. They don't even really care about the damage. Missile gets taken out, and it's just time for Mad Kings to bomb some illusions. Caught out. That's a lot of damage. He doesn't even get a chance to use the press the attack. Fireflies gets in here with a stun. Take these heroes out. What's gonna happen? Atun could turn it around. He doesn't have a blink dagger. He's gonna go around the other side of the trees. He finds MKW. He's gonna be able to get the kill. Can he get anything else using the enrage to get the damage that he needs? And he's gonna get away. Earth Spirit helped out by the Shadow Demon for now, but he's taking a lot of damage. Now he's rolling back over towards Atun. He gets the long range roll, and Atun seeming like he's gonna keep chasing them down a little bit, and he turns around. And Mad Kings only lose one as they take the tier 2 tower out in that lane. There's only one more for them to get. And this is basically how many people would have expected the game to go. Mad Kings absolutely dominating Eternity. At least Eternity did get one kill. But that one kill doesn't mean all that much. So Mad Kings will push in through the top lane. It's time for Eternity to try to defend it. They're smoked up for it. Smoke's gonna break. Fireflies finds Mari before the disruption can come out. There's a disruption, but the wraparound comes in for Mad Kings. Madara's been caught out. That's gonna be the call down. Wall was there as well. Vacuum keeping them. Will track the Disco Pony, takes a lot of damage from it. It's gonna be 2 down on Mad Kings for now. Madara trying to make his way out of here. The carries aren't really in this one at all. He'll swap his way out back into the Diabolical, trying to do out the damage, but it's not going to happen. Ursa not near this one at all, and Eternity get a nice 3 spot. 3 kills, 2600 gold back into this match, but they are still so far behind close to the items that they're going to even begin to need if they want to try to take some better fights when, say, the Ursa or the Weege Commander are in the fight from the onset. This game just looks very hard for Eternity. It's a 10,000 gold lead for Mad Kings, about 4,000 for XP, just because Mad Kings have been pushing in so much. Ursa, he's got a blink dagger. He doesn't see MZW at all at bottom. He will keep pushing in with the Iron Shell. He's hasted up for now, ready to hit these guys down very quickly. But he needs a little bit of support from his team if he wants to get a kill. He doesn't have a stun at this point, which would make it very difficult to secure anything. Be a Dragonlance soon for him. And Eternity, they might just go through their normal routine of running at someone and finding a kill, hoping that it works out for themselves. Gyrocopter steps up at top. Shadow isn't near that push at all. Ursa gets into the lane, and he'll immediately scare the Gyrocopter away. Coming in with a couple of, well, the Centaur, and they're going to get the disruption out onto Ursa in the middle of the lane. He's not got the Aegis. He pops the Enrage, nice off the way, but there's a vacuum out on the floor. Darkseer keeping them in. Atu might need to try to turn this around. Meanwhile, Shadow's going ham on the backside. Ursa is going to be the first one dead. Breathe Fire taking down the Weege Commander. With Shrak, he does end up finding the Earth Spirit, but that is the question. Is that going to be enough? Wolf getting low disruption out onto Lushrak. He needs some help from his team to stay alive. The Rocket Barrage kills him off. Madara cannot turn around to be able to find the kill. As NRS finds another one on the side, Wolf gets the homing missile out onto Madara. Madara getting very low. gotten very low, and he's going to stay very close to the tree line. Wolf ready to chase him down. Disruption's going to come through, but the homing missile is going to be off the mark. It's not going to be the right timing, so the only thing is maybe these illusions do enough to Madara. MKW surging and looking for the vacuum. Is he going to get in range? It's very close, and he is able to get it, but Madara is staying alive with the magic wand. And actually, Swift was able to kill off Mario on the other side of it as well. So perhaps they chased a little bit too far with that. Mad King is throwing away a few kills here. Ursa's looking for Roshan, but his friend is not going to be back at least for a year. Just kidding. A minute and a half. But Eternity are starting to get some levels and items on their heroes. Towercopter at about the same point that Vengeful Spirit is. And she gets towards her Dragon Lance. Let's see if Mad King start to go out on the offensive. They do have the smoke for Ogre Magi. Bringing that in on him. Yeah, mid for now. Probably does need a little bit of help to clear out the mid lane. Not the best at clearing creep waves as an Ogre Magi.
Where's my pension?
So right now, it's really just to wait until Roshan is back up. Mad Kings do have the Alpha Wolf in there, ready to pounce in case the big man respawns. Now it's going to be a tomato creep in there, and the Alpha Wolf starts to attack him. Let's see if we can, let's see who wins this battle. So Alpha Wolf versus Tomato. Seems like the Tomato hasn't even noticed that the Alpha Wolf is there. That health is decreasing. It's going to take a while. And Wolf gets in there and he dominates the Alpha Wolf. That was not fair at all. That was not right. Roshan won't be up for another 2 minutes, but that was just rude. You should not take other people's creeps, especially ones that are duking it out in the Roshan pit. We should disqualify the tomato competition. What's going to happen in the pit now? Ursa finds a ward, and Madara takes his Alpha Wolf back. He says, no, this one's mine. Shadow's still farming up inside the jungle. He'll have his drums soon. Just needs a little bit more gold until he gets those up. Atum gets a nice bloodlust going around for some ancients. He's got a Skull Basher on his way towards the BKB. And Gyrocopter's at basically the same point as the Vengeful Spirit right now. Very close to net worth. So Eternity, they'll walk around the map. It's very clear that both teams should just wait for Roshan right now. And now the fight in the pit continues. Looks like the Tomato Creep, he's back with a vengeance this time around. And the Alpha Wolf, he's going to be whimpering for his life here. Tomato Creep fiercely chasing him down. It's a chase throughout the river. Alpha Wolf going back in. He might have just given up his life here. Another clap is available for Tomato. And the Alpha Wolf jukes it. What a player. As Vengeful Spirit just finds another creep to dominate. It's another tomato. Oh, the traitor. It's not fair at all to Alpha Wolves. And Alpha Wolf, now we've got tomato creep versus Wildwing Ripper, and it's stolen by NRS. This is ridiculous. Never before have we seen such plays with the Helm of the Dominator. Madara slightly caught out in the middle of the jungle. That's the Dragon Tail keeping him out there. But Eternity, they do not want to really engage your enemy. Looking for the vacuum. We'll get it out on the two with the wall. Split Earth is going to keep Dragon Knight there. Meanwhile, Duel on the backside. Octet's a little bit caught in the middle of this one. Wasn't helping the commander at all. He's very low. He doesn't have his enrage either to stay alive. He might want to go back on the wall, but he has to always be careful of the Rocket Barrage. And that's going to be the stun. Fire Blast keeping him there. Atum gets forward, but the Darkseer gets away from him. And Mad Kings take down 3 near the Roshan pit. As it respawns, they don't know about it because their creep inside of the pit is not theirs. But they should be able to see it now, and they take the Wildwing Ripper away. Tomato walks into the to the pit. Wasn't able to do too much though. Top lane still could get pushed in. We do have a ward out here for the Dire. Standing out near it, but little do they know there's also a sentry ward for the Radiant pretty close to that area. Not that it matters all that much.
This
track. Still farming inside the jungle. Dire should have top lane pushing in, but they need it to push in a little bit more before they can find a kill. And they're going to get the first hit dash from the wolf. Back is going to keep Ajin out of it, but it doesn't end up mattering. Ajin has more than enough damage for everybody there. Going forward again, Shadow's there, but MJW walking way too fast for anybody to respond. And Remy, where's the bash? He'll kick Ajin away out of the danger. So Ajin says, well played, sir, to the Ogre Magi. There's a push on the top. MJW here with the Iron Shield. Madara is ready with the Rock Throw as well as another stun. Throughout the Wave of Terror, stunning the Darks here. He still has the Surge for a couple more seconds. Can they find the kill? Ignite will come through, and now they should be able to have it. He dies to the Ignite. This will leave Sword to push in bottom. And Mad Canes can still probably take down a tier 2 in the top lane, so that would open up the shrines for them to kill.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Eternity finding it much more difficult to find kills at this point in the game. And if you look at the items,
Radiant's top tower
not too much
fallen.
Is up right now for Eternity. A couple of small items. It's only 23 and a half minutes into the game anyway. Mad King's starting to break the base, and we're actually missing things. Sword finding kills at the bottom part of the map. Madara very far in here. They already get the Dragon Knight in the middle of everything. Caught on top, but Ajin, he's already enraged. There will be the missile sent out. Ajin stunned by it, but it doesn't really end up mattering. Tier 3 tower going the way of Mad King. There's a vacuum in the wall. It might take a little bit of damage from it, but Lushak easily takes care of it with the Pulse Nova. Shrine has been popped. Ajin might be forced away from this one. Remember, he still has the Aegis. Mad King's starting to get very low. It's all coming through to try to kill Madara. Let's see if his team can help him at all with it. Going in there would be suicide probably for the Venge as he eventually gets hit by that missile. But Mad King still wants to go into the base. Need a creep wave for it, and they do have it now. Shadow's ready with the Diabolic. He has a ton of mana for this. Vacuum through the wall from Madara. Will get stunned as well. Here's the duel. Blade Mail popped as well. Sword in the middle of everything. The Vengeful Spear getting so low. MJW's right next to her with the Iron Shield. She's not able to throw out the Wave of Terror, but NRS, he's super tanky, but it doesn't end up mattering for Mad Kings. They'll be able to get a few kills there. Buyback's being forced out. Ajin's a little bit low. They cannot really go onto this anymore. Shadows, he's actually going to turn around and get the swaggy Darkseer kill with Sword right next to him, trying to heal him up. Ajin gets a pressy attack. Remy getting chased down, looking for a bash. They do get it, but Ajin's decided to head for the Meteor Racks at this time as, and in any case. So Ajin, he'll be trying to take down the full set of racks. Wolf is here, but he can't really do all that much. With Shrak taking care of the creep wave, Ajin taking care of the racks. Maybe they find Ajin here, but he's just going to go forward with the pressy attack again. Sun does come through. Nice disruption keeping Gyrocopter alive for now, but he's going to still be right next to that duel. Can the sword find the duel? He find the kill. Forced out again, getting very low, press the attack, doing some work, he's going to get the Aegis popped. Does Sword decide to go back in here? He has enough mana for a press the attack. He's going to be off cooldown in 3 seconds. Ajin getting away, will get stunned, nice blink out by Sword. Sword decides to go back in, now he's got the Urn of Shadows on him. Basically means that he cannot get back in that one. But look at our net worth, every single hero on Mad Kings are ahead of Eternity. The shrines haven't even fallen yet. Madara starts to get over there. He's going to be killing ancient creeps. And Ursa's not going for the shrine either. He is right there. And look at this. He's so nice. Well, he was nice. He was leaving a little bit of a present for Eternity, but he eventually kills the creep that he was leaving there. So gold is close to 30,000 at this point. XP is getting around 20,000. Mad King's looking for some more action atop NRS. He's gonna back away. Here comes the Blade Mail in the duel. Lots of damage. They cannot keep the Dragon Knight alive. Nice blink away by MJW Atsu. He's got his blink back up in 2 seconds, but it's a little bit far of a range to do anything about. Especially if you can't take care of the Shadow Demon. But with the entire set of racks down at top, that lane will push in. They just need to find some racks in other lanes. Madara's already pushing in bottom. Dominated melee creep leading the way for them. Atune is ready for some kills. They're also pushing in mid. Let's see what Eternity can do around this tower. Vacuum and wall available for MJW. They could catch a lot of them out again. Madara going forward. There's going to be a vacuum wall on the floor. Madara, he's going to swap with the build everything, but he's going to be able to throw out the HUD. Unfortunately, Mad King is just not taking a whole lot of damage. Atune's already got the BKB going. Shadow Beam is going to be the one to fall. Wolf getting out of it as well, but he's not going to be able to run away from this one. Popping the shrine, but it's not going to be enough to save him. Remy nearly dying in the middle of the fountain, but does manage to escape the grip of Atune. Now there's a blink forward. Leaf Miner gets the duel off, and MJW cannot do anything to save his Dragon Knight. That was a buyback by him. It's now going to be a dieback as the Eternity call the GG. Game number one going the way of Mad Kings. And that was probably going to be the expected result anyway, so Eternity do have another shot to try to bring this best of three back. LeBron not really giving a chance, especially considering their performance in the group stage, but we will just have to see. Don't count them over until it's done. So, Mad Kings, they're up 1-0, and we'll go to a break real quick. So, game two coming up pretty soon, guys. And it is that time again, Radiant ladies and gentlemen, back for game number two between Eternity and Mad Kings and Pithily Goom. And Mad Kings currently up 1-0 in this best of three set. So Mad Kings, they are one win away from getting into the next round. And one would think that game one wasn't very too difficult for them. That was English. They go with the Slaughter and Life Stealer for their second draft here. And that is one of those combos that so many teams are just so scared of. And rightly so. Eternity going with the Weaver possibly would be able to get a Shikuchi off, but that is in question against how fast Sparta can go with the remaining Blink Crush combo. Also, Sand King picked up for them as well. So, Eternity. Jaw Ranger hasn't been banned out, so Eternity could go with a Drow to let Weaver go into the support role. But still, it just seems like a very difficult game once the combo is up for Mad Kings. If Swarter can get a fast Blink Dagger, if Lifesteer can get that Armlet and then Echo Saber build, that is going to be a lot of scared bugs running on their map for Eternity so far. And also remember that our next match is coming up at 7. So if there is an hour until that match, or more than an hour, at the end of this one, I'm going to shut down the stream until about 10 minutes before the next one starts, because I don't really feel like keeping the stream up all that long without anything going on. If it's less than an hour, for some reason, if this game takes about, 45 minutes, then maybe we'll keep the stream up the whole time. But I would expect a break in between them just because Mad Kings, they didn't really have too much of a difficult time in game number one. They might have thrown a couple of fights, but in the end, Eternity really could not measure up to the big push from Mad Kings at all. Jakira will get picked up for Eternity now. Maybe even more likely that we see a Drow Ranger pick up. That would put Sand King in the off lane. Be a very push-heavy lineup for Eternity, and makes them have to hit their timings very quickly.
Ten seconds remaining.
And meanwhile, Mad Kings, they go with an early base lineup as well. Getting the Undying here.
Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining.
So Mad King's definitely getting a very aggressive early lineup. It does require the Swarter and Lifesteer to get some kind of farm. But once they have that, things should be pretty easy for them. Eternity going with the Void here. That is a little bit of synergy with the Sand King. Maybe the Weaver, if he gets enough range, can start hitting heroes from outside the Chronosphere. And of course, Macropyre can be just thrown out by Jakira throughout the whole thing. But Mad Kings, they'll go with a pretty known counter to the Faceless Void, which is the Silencer, not allowing him to get around fights at all. So Mad Kings, they are really getting their lineup set up here. And also Silencer are fairly good against Weaver.
Radiant team,
if you can get the Global Silence and then the last word out onto the Weaver in the middle of a fight, that would pretty much ensure that the bug is going to die.
Ten seconds remaining.
Unless, of course, the Faceless Void gets a really well-placed Chronosphere. Eternity do take the puck out of it for Mad Kings. They don't want that big area controller.
Radiant team pick.
And the last Zeus. Bennett will be a Tempo Assassin while Mad Kings get
dire
the Zeus.
Team pick.
I really like when Zeus is picked up. It's something that we don't really see as often. But I really do like it for Mad Kings. Get some nice mix of magic damage. And also, if Sword Art and Lysia are having some trouble finishing off the kills, Zeus can come in with the ultimate. Remaining. So when that burst combo comes in,
5 seconds remaining.
They're definitely going to be able to secure the kill there.
Viper.
Pretty much regardless of who it's going to be against. But now we put the Viper into the mix, which makes things really difficult for a Zeus. He's going to be taking a lot of damage from the Corrosive Skin. So that pretty heavily affects how he's going to be able to do in lane. And he's definitely going to need a lot of help from the Undying. Just to make sure that he doesn't get 100% dominated in mid. I really should turn the music on for during the draft, but I can't change the volume for the draft and in-game, so I don't really like music on the whole time.
Prepare
but maybe
battle.
These players are going to have some champions music going on as they try to play this game, try to come out on top. Zeus going with the two Clarities to start. And he's probably going to be getting the early bottle for himself. Pretty strong with the possibility of getting a lot of bounty runes on him. He just needs to make sure that he's able to get to level 6 at a good time. Smoke up all over the place for Eternity, but it is going to expire now. We just got Jakiro flapping up on the bounty rune. Mad Kings are getting up there, and they have been scouted out a little bit. Sword is going to see Wolf right now. They haven't gotten over to the rune spot, and they would be outmanned there. Meanwhile, at bottom, we've got some damage going out onto MJW. Shadow getting hit here as well. Madara coming in from the side. We do have the Observer Ward blocking off the camp. Time walk out just to make sure that MJW isn't caught out too much there. But the open wound is going to be there. And with the time walk being down, Madara knows that this damage is for sure. So he puts a lot out to MJW early, forcing him to use a couple of those tangos to start.
The battle begins.
I'll follow up on the lights here a little bit. Maybe looking for some more harass of Shadow. Shadow comes around here, and without the Light Steward being in range, he does have to be very careful. They did get the D ward off of the Observer ward as well. Now MJW slowed down. He's going to try to get the creep pull off. But Madara is again here with the open wounds. MJW does have the time walk available. And they're not using the open wounds just yet. MJW getting low. Shadow's going to come around the side. Blaster does have to go back to defending the tower against the creep wave, and NJW will get the self back up to get himself back up to nearly full health. Atun already very low on mana. Trying to use the early harass, and it's actually doing quite a bit to Viper, who doesn't go for the Corrosive Skin first. Would definitely shut down Zeus and his Clarities. But Zeus will have a good early start to the lane. And MJW going for the aggressive time walk against Shadow. Now finally NRS gets the Corrosive Skin up, which means that it's going to be very difficult for Atun to use his second Clarity here. He'll have to bottle up through it. And he's doing quite well to start on the... Oh my god, you've got to be kidding me. So, yep, I just left the overlay on again. I don't know. Been thinking about other things as of late, I guess. Now, meanwhile, at top, Sword is keeping these supports pretty far away. Creepwave has been pulled to all over creation. Burrowstrike's going to come through. Sword in a lot of trouble. The Dual Breath isn't going to hit onto him at all, looking for the crush, but Weaver's going to be able to evade it. Do some damage out onto the Dying. He'll get the Decay off onto two. Burrowstrike again onto Swire, and that will probably nearly be your first blood. Is there enough damage? Wolf going to go forward with the Shikuchi. He's got another crush, though. They might try to turn this around. He's right underneath the Sentry Ward. Can they get this one? Decay onto three. Fireflies, he's got a ton of damage here. Is he going to be able to find anything? Liquid Fire on the backside. Remy, he's going to get the Clarity up. up. Can he get out of this one? He'll juke through the trees, eating through it. Sword will not be able to find him. Maybe Fireflies wants to take the clarity off of him, but he's not going to be able to right now. And Fireflies, he is ready to put out some more aggression. He needs a little bit more mana, though. Take a look at his health. It is going to go down pretty soon, but when you're up against a tri-lane, things get a lot easier. It'll take Wolf down to 420 blaze of health. That bottom, lots of damage to MJW. He's got the time walk over to the side, but Madara wants to keep fighting him. Shadow will get over there. MJW trying to do it, but this time the first blood is for real. With Madara finding it onto the Faceless Void there. I'll take your treatment. So there will be a Faceless Void, a very angry one getting back to the lane. Madara, he's looking for the stun on him, but now he's going to get paid back with an open wounds. MJW trying to back up. He's been slowed down so much. Can he turn this around? No way. Another plus two intelligence for Shadow. He'll get plus four out of this one. Now there's going to be a Burrow Strike. Lots of damage from the Weaver. And pop goes the Slardar. Meanwhile, we have some more aggression. NRS getting very low at mid. Fireflies is ready with the Soul Rip, and this might be a pretty dead Viper. He has two levels up into the Corrosive Skins, so maybe the Soul Rip doesn't do all that much, but there are quite a few units here, and Zeus is ready with his full combo. And he will have enough mana for it as well. Zeus has been slowed down, but Mad Kings are getting a lot of kills on the map very early. Thought that the Viper was going to have a pretty okay time in this lane, but he's not really been able to do too. Ogden's still doing well. Oh, he can't get it in range for the lightning bolt. So Fireflies will chase him over there. Ogden going over as well, but he knows that the Viper's pretty out of reach at that point. Corrosive Skin helping him to get out of trouble. Top again. Remy's right next to the sword. There is going to be a Burrow Strike. Mario's here to do some damage as well. Sword's going to be forced away because of this one, but Fireflies is going to get into the fight. Sword has the crush ready. But it's not really a time to be using that. Madara is still putting out the damage over time on the MJW, and MJW doesn't really have a way to heal up like Madara does. And look at the huge amount of damage that he's taking there. Time walks it off, but until he gets those time walk levels up, it's going to be really difficult to do that every single time Madara starts hitting him. He's going to have to play his cards right in the bottom lane. Wolf goes into Shikuchi, making Undying think twice about the decay. And now look at Madara. He's being aggressive again onto MJW. The only thing that keeps MJW alive for now is going to be the RNG bashes. So we'll do damage on the Madara, but again, we are going to have a pause. Looks like the players are still having a little bit of trouble with the connections. NRS is pretty much untouchable in the mid lane for now. Madara, though, he's been able to out-level him just by a little bit. And he might be able to get up to level 6. The problem is that Mad Kings aren't really in a position to force a fight. Maybe they could get something top, but that's a fight that would have to go pretty far before the Zeus can finish off the kill. A free 225 damage. You know, why does Zeus get a chat line freeze, but I don't think that anyone else does? That seems kind of unfair. Like, if Zeus gets Zeus ult now, then why can't we get something else on the map? Like, give me living armor. Like, that seems like it would be pretty useful. Or, like, TP here, Nature's Prophet. So we are probably ready to get back into the match. We're nearly ready. Mad King still need a little bit. We'll see what the Zeus is able to do when he gets his ultimate up. They might put the aggression out on the NRS. Looking at the Zeus's mana pool, he needs probably a little bit more, so he'll probably bottle up to make sure that he keeps enough for the ultimate, maybe a little bit more damage on the Viper. Yeah, he definitely needs to drink the bottle in order to do anything here. Hopefully we're able to get back into it soon. Also, Wolf is pretty low at top. They need to make sure that they can maintain vision of him so that the Zeus ultimate actually hits onto him. Make sure that he's not invisible. But yeah, we're just sitting here for eternity to, I don't know, maybe take a couple of casualties, because Mad King seemed to be in a really good position right now. Silencer, he's up to level 5. He's gotten so much out of the bottom lane. Midari, he's at level 5 as well, just out leveling the offlaner. He's had a really difficult time taking 2 deaths already. So the work just goes out on mid. Now there's a rotation on the Octoon. Remy, he's ready with the smoke. But when the Zeus, okay, there's going to be the Burrow Strike and the Viper Strike on the Zeus. Can they try to turn this around? He's got to get the ultimate off, but he doesn't have enough mana for it. Shadow comes around the backside, but he's just going to have to TP away because he's not really got a chance to get out of this one. Burrow Strike comes off in 1 second, but it was 1 second too late. MJW, he'll be able to stay at bottom for now with the Silencer going over to mid. That was not really the best rotation from him. He seemed to be pretty out of position. Wasn't really able to help with anything. Undying coming around the side here, looking for the bounty rune. He's gonna force Mario away from it. Mario puts out the Liquify. There's gonna be the dual breath as well. Fireflies has to get away. He's got Remy there with the Burrow Strike as well, and that was way too far in for an Undying without anyone else. It's at the point of the game where Mad Kings, they need to just go onto one hero and say Zeus ult. Now MJW gets so low. Zeus is alive, and MJW will be able to stay alive with the time walk. Zeus not throwing out the ultimate there to kill off the Time Lord. Toon gang low at mid. Sparta will get in ready for a crush, but he also blocks the Zeus in. Shadow, he's fighting MJW. As soon as he time walks, that's going to be the silence, but MJW gets enough health back that that will not be a kill by silencer, or will it? He goes in very far, but he's completely fine getting up to around 30 health. So Eternity aren't giving up too many kills right now, and they are also finding some of their own. Atun wasting the first ultimate onto a Faceless Void that really didn't have a chance of going down. He's also up to his level 6, so they could use the Chrono Spear to try to move here. And that was a bug that died. Sometimes Solorb just does too much damage that you're not really expecting as a Weaver, and or really any hero on the map. And the Weaver falls because of it. Did not get a chance to even skitter scatter a little bit. No skitter scatter at all. MJW, he's getting hit by a couple of those Whitestone procs of Madara, and he's going to be forced into the time walk again. Firefly's taking a little bit of damage at top. He's ready with a crush. He's nearly level 6. He would like to be able to get the Corrosive Haze out, and he does have it now. He's not going to be seen by Remy. Shikuchi forward. Remy is not going to see the Swarta coming through the trees. Burrow Strike only out onto the Swarta. Firefly's taking a lot of damage from it. This focus is a little bit off the mark. Crush onto nothing. So we're trying to get away. The Undying is going to fall over. Beep! Someone's beeping outside. And Sword, he's going to get chased down a little bit. Burrow Strike avail, but it's going to hit. And that's a double kill for Wolf on the top wing. Eternity taking a few kills here away from Mad Kings. And there's not really a whole lot of... Oh, Atun finishing off Remy at top. Securing the kill there. That's nice for him. But still, that Zeus ultimate is not really the one that Mad Kings are wanting. They're wanting Zeus to be able to just throw out the ultimate during the fight to secure a kill or two.
Time is
and try to punish Eternity for going through these fights, but right now Mad Kings just don't really put out enough damage in order to make Mad Kings worried or make Eternity worried about it at all. Antara going back on this. There's going to be a Silence Rose, but lots of damages there. Faceless Void, he is going to get silenced at the end of it as well. Time Walk off, okay. Now we've got the Burrow Strike in from the Sand King as Shadow taking a lot of damage. Atune manages to find the kill on the NRS, and Chromosphere drop down. Lysir could be in some trouble. He doesn't have the Infest available either. Wolf is coming in. That's going to be the Burrow Strike, and they're going to get a double kill on the MJW. Eternity coming back into this one. Eternity, they continue to find a few kills here. Things seem to be going a little bit better for them in this game, but Lysir is still at the top of net worth. Armlet picked up for him, and the Sword Art Lysir combo hasn't even started to come online just yet. MJW getting the Corrosive Haze on him. Sword ready to come in with the creep wave. Fireflies is ready on the other side of this one. Shadow hasn't been scoured out just yet, but there are a couple of tears coming around from the backside. Smoke is going to break onto Mario. He drops down the Observer Ward. Shadow gets away from him for now. Remy, he could go in with the Burrow Strike. Chopped down. Sword coming through. Not getting hit by the Ice Blast at all. Looking for the kill onto Mario. They will be able to find that one. The plus person pays out there. Shadow finds another one. There's another plus two intelligence getting him back up to six. And they dove him pretty far for that one. Undying's going to dance around, and we might actually have a little bit more of an engagement. Burrow Strike away by Remy, but the Corrosive Haze is still out onto him. Sword just wants it on another, but they decide to go back for the tower right now. Wolf gets to push in bottom through all of this. NRS still farming at mid. But Madara's found the tower kill. Now we've got MJW going a little bit far up. Madara is rather low, but there is no Chronosphere at all for MJW with Sword going around the side. And there is complete vision of him. MJW is just sitting here. Most likely wants it to happen. He sees the Infest, and they're going to go elsewhere. MJW looking for the Bash, but he's not going to find it. But they are looking for Jakiro. Jakiro could get caught out here. He just has the Ice Path. Is Sword going to be able to get it? There's going to be the Rage Ward by Madara coming out of the Slaughter just in time, throwing out the Corrosive Haze so that the Lysir has more than enough damage to kill the support. The support is not even at level 6. The Weaver leaving made it so difficult for the Jakiro to stay alive there. He was just trying to put some damage on the tower, and he's gotten it pretty low, but not even close to going down. And the Slaughter Lysir combo is not something that you want to be going down to if you're a support, especially when it doesn't have the Blink Dagger just yet. Fireflies dancing there to the bottom lane. He's got the creep wave here for himself. A lot of support from his team. Kiro's making his way over here. A couple of carries could rotate in here if the fight starts to look good for Eternity. Madara, right now looking at the items, he's on his way towards the Echo Saber. MJW ready with the Chronosphere. Corrosive Haze out on the running. Madara's going to find Jakiro over to the side, and the Rage is going to get used. Can he save him with the Chronosphere? No, it's not even going to be worth committing. Remy over to the side, and before that Rage even ends, he's not going to be able to get the kill there. Buyback by Sand King. He needs to get back into this one. Here's a Chronosphere. NRS ready with some damage. They're going on to Madara, but that's not really the best hero for them. And he can go for an Infest, but he might just turn it around. Going for the Rage. He's going to try to take down NRS. NRS is pretty tanky, but they're going to be able to find the kill there. Fireflies also finding the kill on the MJW. Now Wolf, he's got to use the timeout, but he's not even going to be able to. Too much damage from Madara. Mario also being forced away from this one as well. And there's going to be the Lightning Bolt stopping him in his tracks. Burrow Strike not going to be on the mark on the Shadow. And Remy's not going to be able to find the kill right now either. Fireflies is here. Okay, Corrosive. Okay, Caustic Finale. And that will be a Burrow Strike for the kill. Remy getting further into the trees, but they're going to find the Sand King as well. So the Silencer will not get another plus two intelligence. He's up to 10 right now, but Mad Kings get so many kills off that fight, and they show why they finish at the top of Group A. They are just completely dominating Eternity after that fight. So many kills. Like, how many was that by the end? That must have been 6 or 7. The supports TPing back into the fight for fun. It was not a lot of fun at all. Back in on the, he puts the Observer Ward out there. Tier 2 tower Not getting threatened anywhere on the map. The tier 1 took some damage. Mad Kings haven't been pushing in as much as they usually have, but good news for them is the Slardar now nearly at his Blink Dagger.
Time is money.
They're coming around the side. They are all grouped up at bottom, or most of them are. Slardar is going to go forward. They sees the ward getting taken out there. He could go for the haste rune if he wants to, but he might just save it for Achin, who would love to bottle it up. Fortunately for him, it will not be stolen at all by Eternity. They know that they could go for a D ward there, but they're going to decide not to. Don't want to betray the presence of their team. They've got four grouped up at bottom, soon to be five. As they go for a tier 1 tower. Mad King's ready to push this in. They just send the lone catapult forward, but now there are some the creep wave here to push things out as well. Remy with the Burrow Strike. The Chronosphere now up for the Faceless Void. This could be a nice defense for Eternity, but actually we're going to have the Infest combo out onto the Weaver at bottom. These heroes should probably back away from bottom now as the Weaver got killed at mid. Toon, he could get caught out a little bit. He's going to pop the Haste Rune though, and he's going to try to juke this out. Now the Burrow Strike will find him, and Ice Path is not going to be... Okay, it is there eventually. Mario finding the kill. Zeus was just a tad aggressive there. Really not respecting the Eternity lineup at all. And that was a lot of gold going over to the Dire side after that. Dying dancing away from bottom. Shadow getting some wards off the courier. Blink and the Crush available for Sparta, but Eternity is ready. They have the Chronosphere and the Epicenter. They could go in here. NJW's going inside the... they're going further. They're going to throw out the Silencer ultimate. They know that the Faceless Void is here, but he's a little bit too tanky. That takes the tower anyway. There's going to be a Burrow Strike on the two. Ice Path hitting out onto the Undying Hill, trying to kill himself up with the Soul Rip, but he's not going to do enough. Shadow luckily able to TP away, but now NRS getting chased down by Madara. Achin in the middle of everything. He has to make sure that he doesn't get caught off by the damage. Nice crush by Sword, keeping the Zeus alive for now, but the Ice Path is going to put him in a lot of danger. MJW trying to get some time walk off, but it's not going to happen. Here comes the Epicenter, but it's going to keep going even after the Sand King dies to Madara. Sword over to the side. That's a triple kill for Madara. Wolf looking for a little bit more, looking for the Courier. That's Shikuchi, and yep, they'll get the Gemini Swarm off. Ultra kill, though, for Madara. Get him the Rampage. Mario, he's going to get chased down. There's the Infest into Sword. Sword's looking for the Crush. He's not going to be able to find it just yet. They'll give him the Rampage! Madara finding every single kill on the bottom lane. Give him some more kills, guys. Why not? Echo Saber and some more. Desolator soon for the Lifestealer. He is absolutely insane this match. And look at that. Five little skulls underneath the Eternity squad. Remy, he's invisible. He's being sneaky, sneaky. Sand King over to the mid lane. Burrow Strike hurts out into the Silencer. He will be healed up. And look at all the damage. Remy forced away. He's supposed to be a tanky Sand King. The Silencer does pop, but it's going to be a twofer on the mid lane for Mad Kings. And Madara has shown up here as well. And this is the point where Eternity make their exit. They do not want to stay on this mid lane at all, because this Lifestealer is way too scary, especially with Sword walking around with the Blink Dagger. This Lifestealer can be carried anywhere on the map that he wants. Mario seems to be working towards a 4 staff for now. And MJW just desperately trying to get a few items. Probably be the Vlads for him. Look at that. Madara, 10,000 net worth at 18 minutes. He hasn't even farmed that much. He's more farmed heroes than anything else. Going 11-1 so far. When he has that rage going, he's just got so much damage against Eternity. Ridiculous. And here comes Sword again. Double crush. They're right next to the shrine, but it doesn't mean anything at all. There's a Burrow Strike keeping the Swarder there. Lifestealer is going to abandon him. He doesn't want the kill streak to be going their way on the Dire side, but I don't know if it's going to matter. Wolf eventually finds the kill. Lifestealer did not want in on that one at all. Just wanted to farm the bug on his Schwang. So do give up the Swarder for Jakiro. A little bit more gold to Eternity after that one. And this is not the talents that Lifestealer has. Interesting how these talents can make supports a little bit more picked up. So the Undying, you see that it gets plus 90 gold per minute. And that can be pretty substantial. Especially when you're having difficulty finding gold as a support. That's a really nice thing to have. Almost makes me think that we should rethink the talents a little bit if certain supports are going to be, or certain heroes are going to be more valued as a result of that. Grouping up in the mid lane, we have the Infest and the Smoke Sword moving in. They are underneath the Observer Ward, but they're going over to the top lane. Couple of heroes there, they could get caught out. MJW is going to get that smoke broken. Can he time walk away fast enough? They're going to blink forward. They bait it out, and look at that. Two shot by Madara. It's absolutely insane in here. This is ridiculous. It's as quick as a blink. Crush and Sword might be able to find another. He'll get it to the Shakiro. He'll get a Viper Strike in return. There's the Burrow Strike. Lots of damage on the Sword, but the Silencer Ultimate is there, making it so that Eternity have to back away. NR is getting chased down by a ton of zombies. The Wolf is getting a lot of pressure as well. They need a blink. Crush, they'll find it. Viper, he's flying, but he's soon going to be dying. Mad King's getting another kill. And it is just an unstoppable machine of pain that Mad Kings have constructed here. 1100 gold to them after that one. Mad Kings, it's just their game the whole entire way. TP in. There's the epicenter, but he can't even get it off. They'll get a three-man chronosphere, but what good is it anyway? MJW, he's got a time on the way. He's going to have to use it now. He took a lot of damage there, but Shadow is going to chase him down with all those waves of wisdom. Doesn't even need that big damage. Slarder with the blink. The crush to the other side of the wall. You can't stop this fish, but actually the Weaver might be able to do so. Last day later hit will find him. Hang around a little bit just for fun, but Mad Kings have taken another tier 2 off the map, and they are still finding the hero kills as well. Maybe even a strategic death by the Swardar. Might think about Roshan pretty soon. Should be rather easy to take with the Desolator and the Corrosive Haze once Swardar respawns. Push next, but look at Madara. Look how deep he is. He's got a double damage rune. He's just going right for the tower. Weaver tries to stop him. He's going to infest into a creep. They can't even take him down. Madara going 1v1 versus the tower, not even worrying that other people might show up. There is a blink dagger on Sand King, but exactly what good does it do here? Exactly what can Eternity do right now? They'll knock the Centaur creep out of the Roshan pit. Sword ready with the Corrosive Haze after Madara pops the Roshan Lincolns with open wound. And that will be the Aegis going to Mad Kings. Madara picking it up. First Roshan of the game. We have a tier 2 in top, a tier 2 in bottom. Mad King's open to taking pretty much anything they want right now. 12 intelligence stolen on Silencer. He's got his ultimate back up. And we should see a smoke in from Mad King's. They're all grouped up in the mid lane. And then drop a little bit. There's the smoke now. Sword. He's got the infest into him. He's feeling pretty happy about it. Lifestealer inside and makes him happy. He's going to go with the sprint. Blinks to the high ground. That seems like a preemptive blink as Eternity are fleeing the scene. He doesn't really have a whole lot of vision, but they are going to now see Wolf. He's coming in here. He gets a Shikuchi around. Atun could see him, but they're not going to get to him right now as Wolf gets back into the base with the Shikuchi, but Swarder's going forward. About going on to this one. The smoke hasn't been broken just yet. It's going to expire now. And the Dire don't have vision of this at all. Sword happening to be on the mid lane. Is anyone going to try to push this out? This is a very dangerous situation for Eternity. Looking for the blink. There's the crush. They need some vision though, and they don't have it of the Weaver. Sounds for ultimate is there. Viper killed off. Now they're looking for the Weaver kill. He still sounds for a couple more seconds, but he does get the timelapse off before the Mad King Squad can kill him. Lots of damage with the Desolator, but that Blink Crush is going to be up pretty soon. In fact, they do have it now. Drosa pays out the Wolf, and he doesn't have the time lapse. He's got to stay out of this fight for now, but Mad Kings, they might have taken enough damage that's going to force him away from here. Mario is smushed up to the side, but they're just not really going to be able to find a way to get it into the fight. Mad King's waiting on the high ground. It is now daytime. They are not seen over there at all. Mario just throwing out a couple of attacks. See who the one that's going to be caught out is. Because Mad Kings don't have a whole lot of vision of the high ground. Maybe sending someone out to bait. Watching sent out to the mid lane, and he'll blink away. The rest of the team, they'll back up. It's time to defend bottom. Maybe also take another tower off the map. Guard takes a couple of last hits with that infest, and they'll try to very quickly push in bottom. Going very fast now, and it's going to be an AC from him soon. So this armor, this supposed armor that Eternity had, it's going to be melted very quickly. As long as the Lifestealer can keep attacking, these heroes will go down just like butter. It's like a lot of butter. As if they didn't already. Madara ready to go onto this tier 2. There is a tier 2 being pushed on the other side of the map. MJW trying to get some work done on it. But Mad Kings, they are not necessarily going to have to stop with this push. They have the Aegis being reclaimed in 2 minutes by Roshan. And Madara will keep pushing this one in. He'll get healed up by the urn. And he immediately goes for the tier 3 tower. This is not something that Eternity can try to take right now on the other side of the map. They can't go for any kind of race. Madara juking around the ice path when the rage ends, and Sword ready with the blink forward. Madara getting low, they take down the tier 3 tower, and Sword is ready with another infest bomb. And there's the blink forward, MJW, there's this global silence as well. They're looking for the Jakiro kill. Madara trying to get forward. Forstead's gonna take him even further into the base. He's gotta be careful, he does have the Aegis up. There's the Burrow Strike on the back end, but they don't have any interrupt for the Sand King. Actually, they do. Crush off right at the end from Sword. Sword's going to go down. Lifestealer in the middle of the Macropire. He's got to get away from it. MJW throwing out the Chronosphere. Lifestealer in the middle of the Macropire, but it does end eventually. Burrow Strike will be there immediately after the end of it. But now Atun just going ham. Triple kill for him. Madari is going into the base as well. Mario, we've got buybacks galore from Eternity, but you cannot run from having Atun looking for more. Rampage for Atun. Let's get it all over the place. Madara is looking for some kills as well. Atun taking a lot of damage from the Weaver. They just need to get those bugs off of them, but the Wolf is not going to just leave it there. And Madara, he's going to be forced out of this one. Ultra kill for Wolf. Does he find a Rampage? Trying to find Madara, but he's going to try to turn around underneath the Sentry Ward. Can Wolf get away? No way! Madara is going to win the man fight. He's got the bug on him. Might decide to go for some racks. He'll be able to find the ranged racks, no problem. Sand King respawning in 3 seconds. And Madara looking for the melee racks. It's only a Sand King, but the problem is that the Burrow Strike is up and he is going to get hit by it, but it's just not nearly enough damage onto the Lifestealer. He pops the armlet. He's going to stay in the sandstorm for now. Madara finds the Rax Jakiro into this one, but the rage and... Ooh. I guess that was a bad armlet toggle. Sword is ready, but the question is ready for what? He is going to have the Blink Crush if he wants it. Atun, he is TPing in, crushes out. Atun ready with some big damage. Remy caught out again. Throws the phase. Atun just waiting for that perfect time to ultimate. Our NRS right in the middle of everything. Force that forward. Crush out onto him. They need to get this Viper down. Jakiro flip flapping away, but he's going to be dead. Flying to the ground there, and Atun gets a double, looking for the triple. Double bash from Sword. How long can he go on with this? Weaver into the fight. The bugs are going to be all over the place. Wolf uses the BKB again, looking for Fireflies. He's taking a lot of damage. The Gemmate Swarm will be able to find him. Now MJW right next to the Atun. Zeus, he gets a triple again. Wolf also forced into the time-lapse. There is tons of damage for him now. There's a silence. He'll try to get away. Sword took a lot of damage, but there's going to be the Force Staff forward and an ultra kill for Atun. He doesn't even need the Crush Beat. Because this Slardar is just a bash ward. 2,600 gold to Mad Kings after that. A TP in by Madara getting quickly into the base. And will very quickly melt to the hands of Lifestealer. Sand King up, Jakiro up. They're trying to salvage their base. They're trying to salvage their hopes in the upper bracket of the COD League playoffs. But, well, I don't even know if Boar would be able to, would have been able to perform any close to how you would need to in order to beat Mad King. Boar strike, there's the ice path. A nice path onto Lifestealer, keeping him there for a couple seconds. Has the rage to get away, but it's just going to be an infest in the sword. We might be able to turn around, double four staff away. Mario, is he too far up? Sword about to come in. They don't have vision of him. Sword getting ever closer. He's got to be careful of the vision, and he doesn't wander through it just now. He's going to go around to the side. Doesn't have vision, or does have vision there of the Sand King, but they're looking for something inside the jungle, also trying to push out the top lane. They haven't even killed all the tier 2 towers, but they've taken 3 racks off the map. Remy moves forward. Swarder could catch him out. He just places down the observer ward, and he's going to stay safe for now. Shadow, he's got the Ascension Ward to put right next to the Observer. They keep the top lane pushing in thanks to Optune. Sword is in here with the Lifestealer inside. He is looking for that big pickoff. No vision here still for Eternity as he just sits there waiting for someone to dare to come up and clear the creep wave. Be careful. Sword in for the Jakiro. They won't even be able to save him. The Jakiro just dies too quickly. And he stays inside the Swarder for so long that Lifestealer has another infest right after it as well. He'll TP down towards bottom. They know that Wolf is here. They want to take down a bug. Four staff forward looking for the blink. Actually, they don't need it. They've got the Shadow Blade and a very dead bug at bottom. Madara also has a boost of travel available, so it's not like it's going to be any kind of reprieve for Eternity. Last word goes out onto the Sand King, and he's taking a lot of damage here as he is silenced. Shadow trying to move forward, putting another Urn of Shadows out on the Remy, but the Shrine has been popped. Madara goes up for a little bit of damage onto a tier 3. They're just looking for that last one there. They could also back up and go for the Shrines if they wanted to, but Madara, he knows that victory could be in the cards here for him, so he starts to just go for it. Onto the high ground, he's going to be hit with the Burrowstrike in return. Remy immediately gets out. Chronosphere onto 3. That's a very wide Chronosphere. Now that Silence Ultimate comes through, Lifestealer taking a lot of damage. He does have the Infest. He needs to get into the creep, but he keeps getting stunned. Now he does get into it. Pops out. He needs to get that damage off, but he's popped out in the middle of the Macropyre and the ice path. Epicenter in, buyback by Lifestealer. He knows that the victory should come here. Another Shrine pop. Can they kill off the Sand King? He's looking for a Burrow Strike wave, but it's just not going to come off on cooldown on the time. And that is a Nimbus going in on the racks at top, not doing any damage, just forcing everybody away. GG called. Eternity will get knocked down to the lower bracket of the COD League playoffs. Well, that was a very interesting game. I can't really say I expected too much from Eternity. Just filling the spot at just at the last minute for Boar, who had dropped out. But just considering how Mad Kings were doing, it would have taken a very big effort from them in order to win the match. So that will do it for our first one of the night. Next one in about an hour and 13 minutes. So I will shut off the stream after we play a couple of ads on our way out. But if you enjoyed the cast or you have a couple of things for me to improve on, make sure you follow me on Twitter at PythianLegume, and that is underneath the stream if you have trouble spelling it. Also on twitch.tv/PythianLegume. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching the COD League season number 4. We'll be back with another match at about 7 p.m. Eastern, so make sure you don't miss that one. It will definitely be one to watch. But for now, wish you good night, and as always, cheers.
Place your bets on more than 15 esports games using the worldwide payments, Bitcoin, and beyond for 24/7 support and bonuses for free esports bets on gg.bet.